Welcome to another Lost in Translation Bible study. All right, so this is the original scriptures, or the oldest versions we have of them. Don't have any of the crazy accent marks that were put on between 800 and 900 AD, or the oldest examples of those that were found. But these predate all of that stuff by about 1,000 years. When you get down to this one, it's BCE 200. And this is just beautiful. This is Genesis 1. This is 100 BC. And the oldest Masoretic ones they found in 800-900 AD, because they like to control the narrative. And this is why this word, aten, Hebrew goes right to left, English left to right, by the way. They may change it to a TH, pretending it's a different word. They add another extra T here. This is the T letter. There's no extra T here, so this is a lie. And aten, to try to say, it's totally a different word. Over here, it means ass, okay? And over here, it's furnace. Okay? So here, he has his maidservants and asses and camels. I wonder if that's even camel, but I'll get to that some other time. Anyway, and they infer she there, that it doesn't have she actually in the translation. Huh. It's just ass. Over here, furnace. Huh. So he wasn't having furnaces follow him around, right? So let's check this out. Ah. So the threat was to be thrown into the midst of a burning and fiery furnace. Or ass. Was that could be pretty scary if it's like a really huge one, and ew. But anyway, either way, it's a pretty sad story. It's pretty great to be saved from it. Could possibly change the narrative, though, or show God has a greater sense of humor than anything we've been shown in the Bible thus far. Anyway, I hope you got something out of this. I did. Don't let false religion shame you in any way. As Jesus said, the traditions of men make scripture of no effect. In Mark 7:13 is one of the many places he says that, and that's why I love Jesus, because he loves God. God is love and truth, and the truth shall set us free. So don't let false religion shame you out of any of your dreams.